On the 21st of February in Sofia, long-awaited protest of the parties in opposition was held. Two main protests were held in the center of Sofia against the politics of the three-party coalition, which ruled Bulgaria from 2005. In the same time in the parliament, the same parties in opposition debated the protest voting. Maybe when now the events happening in Serbia are the most important for international community, but about inner situation here, the union of the opposition parties shows hidden crisis in Bulgaria and thinks that neither government coalition, neither opposition has to show something really alternative to the Bulgarian people. The corruption in the ruling parties is something that there is no necessary to be proved. But all of the criticizing leaders of the very different opposition forces is another thing which is not necessary to be proved. Many of the leaders of right-wing parties already were in the power and corrupted scandals are connected with them. Today the protest vote will be discussed again in the parliament and probably there will be a decision. But nothing can change at this moment the new liberal policy of the government. Prime Minister Sergei Stanishev said that if the opposition make new government, it will not working because very different political programs there. That is true. Right parties like Union of Democratic Forces and Democrats for Strong Bulgaria stand for total privatization. GERB is the populist new union of the former boss of the police and present mayor of Sofia, Boyko Borisov. They stand for minimal participation of state in the economic protest. But Boyko Borisov is strongly connected with state bureaucracy and former force structures, which still exist. On the other hand, in that so-called united opposition is the extreme right party ATTAC, which stands for nationalization and has xenophobic rhetoric against party of Bulgarian Turks and Gypsies in Bulgaria. In the different corner is VMRO. They are also right-wing, with racist rhetoric, but not so extreme like ATTAC, and pro-NATO and European Union in difference with ATTAC. It is really a coalition which will not working, but Prime Minister Stanishev forgets that his own so-called socialist party is not socialist from many times and follows the same neoliberal policy, also participating in the coalition with the party of the former king, who they expelled from the country as communist party in the past. And also they are in coalition in the government with party of Turkish minority, which was discriminated by the same former communist party in the past, and was campaign of turning Turks into Bulgarians. So all of this will never change really the situation in Bulgaria in the times that government has to decide also on important international cases like this one about Kosovo, for an example. I don't know if the protest vote will pass today in the parliament, but two things are very clear now. One of it is that anyway, if government parties or opposition ones are in the government, will follow the same neoliberal policy with exception of ATTAC, which calls for something like dictatorship and right-wing populism. The other thing is that Nevermind organizes anti-government protests, and one thing is true and real. Social anger and unrest of common people who cannot stand anymore, neoliberal reforms, and who living in really very bad social conditions. For AG student, Ivan Stefanov, Sofia, Bulgaria.